Hi, I'm Charlotte, and today I'm going to be talking to a famous researcher about the American Cancer Society and saving people's lives. What did you want to be when you grow up?
Well, when I was your age, I thought I wanted to be a scientist. My dad was a chemist, and we used to have this chemistry set down in our basement, but he never let us use it. He figured we'd blow up the house. But it gave me a pretty good grounding in science. And so when I was growing up, that's what I thought I wanted to be. How did you become involved with the American Cancer Society? You do the Relay for Life?
Yeah.
And how long have you been doing that?
Since I was a baby.
Really? What would you like to be when you grow up, Charlotte?
A scientist.
Great.
If I wanted to be a scientist, what should I do?
Well, the first thing you should do is you should make sure and study really, really hard and do really well in school. But I think it's also important that you take some time and explore lots of different subjects. Learn how to read really well, how to write really well. But the most important thing, study really hard and get really good at science.
What discovery did you make to help the American Cancer Society?
When I came here 20 years ago, I was devoted to finding a way that we could kill cancer cells without harming normal cells. And through the work that we did here, we developed a drug called Gleevec for a particular type of leukemia based on research funded by the American Cancer Society. We took a disease that was uniformly fatal, and now we've turned it into a manageable condition with a once-a-day pill with minimal side effects.
How does it feel to be an ACS legend?
Well, I don't like to think of myself like that. I'm here to take care of patients and help people do even better.
Our relay is August 3rd. I'd like to invite you to come walk with me and my relay family.
I would love to do that. I will put that on my calendar. Thank you. I'd like to wish the American Cancer Society a happy 100th birthday. The funding they provide to researchers like me is making such a huge difference in our efforts to end cancer as we know it.